It's Madden NFL 24, and coming up, it'll be no holds barred between AFC South rivals. It's the Tennessee Titans and the Jacksonville Jaguars, and it's all up next.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to the Sunshine State and Everbank Stadium here in Jacksonville. Today, it's an intra-division matchup in the AFC South, as it'll be the Tennessee Titans taking on the Jacksonville Jaguars. Brandon Gaudin joined, as always, by Charles Davis. But Charles, a lot of optimism here in the Sunshine State about these Jaguars. They're the defending AFC South champs. They won a playoff game last year and gave the Chiefs all they could handle in the divisional round.
And last season was seen as one where they were just going to try and rebuild and regroup. And they did all of those things and then exceeded expectations. Quietly, they've amassed a lot of talent, and they expect to make another run in their division.
And meanwhile, the Titans last year, they were one of those strange statistical anomalies, CD. When you look at their defense, they were the best in football, number one overall against the run, but worst in the league, number 32 against the pass.
And part of the reason they were number one against the run, the struggles they had slowing people down through the air, so people threw it and threw it and threw it and had great success. And a team that should have been in the playoffs last year somehow managed to miss it.
The ball on the tee, we're set for football. And off we go from Jacksonville. From the end zone, it's D'Ernest Johnson. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Well, the Jaguars ready to go on offense for the first time, and they're led by the former number one pick in the draft in his third season now, Charles, Trevor Lawrence.
The word is potential, potential, potential. Think about this guy from the time he was in high school, one of the top prospects going to college, coming out of college, mentioned as a generational-type quarterback. He looks the part. Tall, big arm, surveys the field, and can take off and run when under duress.
Going to the air right away, Lawrence. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. They called the corner blitz, and Roger McCreary, he got in there and earned the sack. A lot of talk the other day about them wanting to quiet this home crowd early and often. Very first play of the game, they do just that.
You're exactly right about that, because that's often a conversation when you go on the road and you travel. Hey, let's take the crowd out of it. What a great way of doing so by putting the quarterback on the deck.
A situation they'll certainly want to avoid going forward. An early second and long they're facing. A man coming off an 1,100-yard campaign last year. Here's Travis Etienne. And a nice gain there as he'll be taken down just shy of the 20. Give him 8, maybe 9, but they're still left with a third and long upcoming.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. They'll try and set up the screen to ETN. And just shedding him off there. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13.
And as you're game planning as a staff, you go through all the different ways you can neutralize the other guy's pass rushers. Extra linemen, leave a tight end in, bring the running backs back in to block. Or you can do this, a little simple screen pass, and it works to perfection.
Here's the rookie from Auburn, Tank Bigsby. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
Here now, second and 9 from the 39-yard line. Lawrence. His throw incomplete.
Well, that's a defensive coordinator's got to be happy with that result. They took away all options downfield and forced the incompletion.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. Here's Lawrence to throw. He wants it all for the end zone. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Now give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down.
You get a sense of what this game plan might be. They think they can take a few home run shots against this defense. They tried it there on the opening drive, but that ball's incomplete.
So on fourth down, here's Logan Cook to punt for Jacksonville. Kyle Phillips deep for Tennessee. And this will be taken at the 13. A very nice punt that time, but they get 11 back on the return. And it'll be Titan football. So a new face at quarterback for the Titans in 2023. It's the 24-year-old rookie out of Kentucky, Charles, Will Levis.
I tell you what, when he is on schedule for that week, secondaries take notice because you've got to stay alert back there on every snap. A truly powerful arm, one that's capable of challenging any level of the defense on any given play. That's why so many scouts preach arm talent when preparing for the NFL draft. A quarterback with arm strength to make every throw in the book, he's an asset to have in any offense.
The NFL's second leading rusher in 2022. Here's Derrick Henry. And somehow he's going to get a yard out of this as he fought through that first contact. It's second down.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
A shot downfield for Burks. And this will be caught at the 30. A big play that time for the Titans. 51 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. A shotgun handoff to Henry. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
In motion is Phillips. He's going to get it on the jet sweep. Oh, this one, he may need to go back to the drawing board. He's going to be swallowed up right away. Now, hang on here a second. Looks like a Jaguar in some obvious discomfort from that last play. So as the medical staff takes a look, we'll step aside. The slot man in motion right. Now, they'll fake the jet sweep and run up the middle with Henry. He pushes forward from maybe 3 down to the 6-yard line. Defensively, I think they can smell a stop ball right around the 5 here, brings up 3rd.
And I think what they've done is they put doubt in the minds of the offensive guys. What do we do? Because now you don't have a go-to play. Either side they pick, throwing it, running it.
Got a man, and it's taken in for a Titans touchdown. Chigakonkwo. From 6 yards away. And the Titans are on the board first here this afternoon. An ideal start for them, really. You force the punt, and then you go down and score.
And you've got to see a fist pump on the sideline from the head coach, don't you? Because he's turning to his bench, and he's telling his team, this is how we prepare. Force the punt, go downfield and score. I told you guys, it's just like a boxer in the gym preparing for the fight. Now we get to turn it all loose.
Extra point up and good by Folk, and it's now a 7-0 game. There's the Titan kick team as they run up and send this one away. Johnson won't return this, and the football will come out to the 25. So time to see Jacksonville again on offense for the second time here in this game. Defense got the better of them last series, forcing a punt. See if they make a few changes in the game plan here and try to get points out of this drive. First and 10. On first down, Lawrence. This one complete to Christian Kirk. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, first down.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
And his throw here is incomplete.
How about that? Red man coverage and decided to test him early. But it proved up to the task and forced the incompletion.
Here now is 2nd and 10, again from the 41. Here's Lawrence. And the Titan defense steps up here, and down he goes. The sack by Harold Landry, the former Boston College Eagle.
And this is what you've got to do against a quarterback like him. You've got to keep him in the pocket and not let him get to the perimeter, because once he gets outside, that's where he can really hurt you.
Now Lawrence on 3rd and long. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Every offense tells you they want to come out and start fast. That's not unusual at all. But this group, they've yet to get much rolling through their first two drives. It looks like they're going to have to give up the football again after this one.
On 4th down, on is Logan Cook to punt. This first punt, 48 yards. This one looks equally as good. This is brought in at the 21. So a change of possession here on the punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Titans coming back onto the field for their 2nd drive. And they'll be looking to make this a 2-score advantage. Had the touchdown on their 1st drive, Charles. Hey, they can get up 2 scores here on the road. That's a heck of a start.
And not only have they thought about it, I wonder if they visualized it. I remember playing, and they used to turn the lights out in our meeting room and run through a situation like this and say, just think about what it would be like to be up on the road and take the crowd out of it. Maybe they did some of that.
Yeah, he tries to keep the legs churning, but he's going to be stopped behind the line.
Two things to watch. First, his strength and being able to break out of that initial contact. But at his size, once you slow his momentum, it's hard for him to get it started again and end up tackling him behind the line of scrimmage.
A 2nd down throw from Levis. A short throw taken in by Okonkwo. And he'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. So, Charles, take nothing away from this young man under center, because I know people think he's got a very bright future in this league, but I have to figure the defensive coordinators love the thought of squaring off against a rookie quarterback.
And especially if they have guys they can put together a game plan with that's going to confuse, disguise a lot of coverage.
Levis in trouble. Down he goes. Josh Allen gets in there to drop him for a loss of 13 yards, and it's also 4th down now.
The lessons will continue, but this rookie, he's got to learn how to read situations just a little bit better. That far behind the line, he's got to find a way to get rid of the football and not take the sack, whether it's with his legs or just throwing it away.
On 4th down, Ryan Stonehouse on the punt. A beautiful fake. Call that a 46-yard punt, though they did get 9 back on the return. And the Jaguars go on offense, 1st down and 10. And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on 3rd down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice, so they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a 1st down and change our momentum?
Now ETN to start the drive. He'll get this up to about the 44.
That was a pretty good job defensively to hold them to a 2-yard run, but I've got to think this offensive line, they're asking their quarterback for a different type of a run, one that they rely on, one they have confidence in, one they feel like they can block.
This is 2nd and 8. Another tote for Etienne, and they'll hold him to 3 there as he takes this up to the 47. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Now Lawrence to throw. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now 4th down.
Well, this first half has not gone according to plan so far, offensively, or even defensively for that matter. They could use a big-time spark somewhere, but it's not going to come on this drive as they have to punt this one away.
The Cook now on to punt as he gets this one away. And that hits at the 6 and carries into the end zone for a touchback. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And they'll blow that one up back at the 16-yard line. That tackle by Trayvon Walker. Nice play. He blows that up behind the line of scrimmage.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Now Levis. And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the first down marker. He turned that into a nice gain, gets him 8 yards closer for 3rd down.
This early in the game, it's all about making steady progress downfield, hoping to lead to early points. And you can do it with your actual play calls, or sometimes something a little more improvised, as we just saw there.
Levis on 3rd down. On the out route, he's got Burks. And he will have a Titans 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
They kept the receiver in the short field, but that let his quarterback get the ball quickly to him before either guy in double coverage could react.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30. They'll try the right side with Henry. And shutting him off, now open field. And a good stiff arm there before he's brought down on a nice little game.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive lineman creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before, they always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
2nd down, they go again with Henry. And running with power here. He's still on his feet. Touchdown, Titans. Derrick Henry, 60 yards. And the Titans are off to a 13-0 first quarter lead.
I know I should keep the focus and the spotlight on the hero that just scored, but tackling's been an issue for this defense all game long. I can't set that aside. We just saw it again here. Missed tackles leads to his long touchdown run.
On for the extra point is Folk. And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead. So the drive there, 5 plays, 80 yards. And Derrick Henry able to finish it off with a touchdown run. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Johnson won't return this, and the football will come out to the 25. Out comes the Jacksonville offense as they get set to take over here. They've been outplayed early, no question. Down 14-0 already as they come up first and 10. Now Lawrence. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Really good coverage all over the field. It took away his intended read and almost dared him to try for his guy out of the backfield. No surprise on that one. It doesn't connect.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Lawrence will throw into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Sean Murphy Bunting. And this one will be brought back to the 22. So more problems here in this first quarter. Already two scores down, and here they give away the football.
And if I'm the head coach, I think it's time to start lighting a fire under some of these guys. Now, you have to do it within your personality. They can't perceive it as fake. But I'd go get after some guys because they don't look ready to play to me. They look flat, uninspired. It's time to get moving.
The Titans offense now, they get ready to do battle again here. And they'll have good field position here following the interception and a chance to build on their lead as they start with a first and 10. Levis now on first and 10. And he gets this one to Burks. That's good. The completion there for 7 yards, and it's second down. It's a gain of 7. Brings up second and 3 at the Jaguars' 15-yard line. Henry up the middle. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. 93 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start. Now they're making a real first quarter statement with a run game, no doubt.
For those who remember old school football, running it, establishing things, seeing backs find holes, get through them, they've got to like what they're seeing from this unit so far. Right now, they've decided to, as you've said, establish.
And it's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tennessee. DeAndre Hopkins. From 8 yards out. And the Titans have moved out in front by 3 touchdowns. Boy, still in the first quarter, and look out. I mean, they are on pace for over 80 points in this game. I don't know that they'll get there, CD, but this has been impressive to watch so far.
That certainly would be history in the making, wouldn't it, partner? I'm glad we're here to actually watch and see if it actually happens, although, like you, I have my doubts, but they are firmly in control of this game.
Full connects on the extra point, and it's now 21-0. So how about this for a start? 21-0 here in the first as they kick this one away. Now here's Johnson. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. The Jacksonville offense set to begin their next drive.
Well, CD, you kind of feel like they're in a bit of a danger zone right here because now you're down 3 scores, and I know we're in the first half, but the way this offense hasn't been able to generate anything, you feel like they probably need to get something going on this drive, right?
Yeah, and sometimes I overuse that this is an important possession. But I think this has to be the possession where they come up with an answer, because only a few teams in league history have ever come back from a four-score deficit. And if they don't score here, that's what they could be facing the next time they get the ball.
Second quarter now from Jacksonville, and it's the Jags with the football, as they've got it with a second and 14 upcoming. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. His first catch, good for 16 and a first.
And I don't think there's any question that this offense is going to need to hit on a few more plays like this. It's been a difficult first half for them, to say the least. And I do believe if they want to get back in this game, they need to start right now. It's kind of like making adjustments. If you try and wait until the half, it's probably too late. They need to get going right here.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
Oh, that was a nice job there. Quarterback and receiver reading the pressure that was brought. They both knew it was going to open up the middle of the field. Nice little shake and bake at the line of scrimmage, got right into his route. And the quarterback hit him in stride, and he was able to run free after the catch.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They'll throw this out wide and complete it to Ridley. Call it a gain of 3 on the play, and it'll be second down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Here's second and 7. Running out of the gun with ETN. 10 yards there, good enough for the Jags' first down.
Some big plays in the passing game on this drive, and here's one out of the running game. So the passing game loosening things up. Now there's room to roam.
First and 10 at the 33-yard line.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. And they'll go again with ETN. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down.
They suspected it. It was a power play up the middle coming at them. And boy, were they right. That defense got downhill in a hurry and limited them to just a couple on first down.
From the 31, here's second down and 8. Now Lawrence. That's caught by his tight end, Evan Engram. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans' 18. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Looking to throw, Lawrence. And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. Zay Jones, an 18-yard touchdown grab. And the Jaguars are able to make some inroads here to that deficit. That seemed like a much-needed touchdown after 21 unanswered points to start the game.
It's not often that you equate a football game to a golf tournament, but it's like you don't want to shoot yourself out of the tournament too early. So they needed that touchdown to make sure that they got an opportunity to not just get back into this game, but a chance to win it later if they continue to play well.
McManus's point after is good, and they'll cut the lead to 21-7. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. This taken in at the goal line. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Here's Tennessee ready to begin this drive offensively. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that in Charles's defense. They were very frustrated after giving up 6 the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better
and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Now left side on the swing pass. No gain on the play there. It'll be second down.
That's a nice job defensively to make sure everyone was accounted for, because ordinarily you pick up the guys downfield and sometimes you forget about the running back. In this case, they did not and dropped him for no gain.
Second and 10. Here's Levis. A short throw taken in by Okonkwo. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
The Titans on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Levis to throw it. Trying to force it to Hopkins, and it's intercepted. And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20. They've got a pretty comfortable lead right now, but maybe a little too careless with the football that time for the rookie.
I think the key word there is comfortable. And there's two schools of thought on it. With that type of a lead, maybe you can take a few more chances because you have a cushion. Others will tell you, don't eat up the cushion with careless play. He'll learn to ride that line as he moves on in his career.
Trevor Lawrence, helmet on, ready to go as he brings out this offense. 5 for 5 that last drive, touchdown pass as well. He was clicking. Receivers, I don't want to be cliche, but running really solid routes too.
And what I love about it is when you look across any team, all right, the body types of the receivers are usually different. The way that they get open, different as well. Some of them use power to get open. Some of them use those head fakes and subtle moves. Some of them just use pure speed. And the really good ones, when they're established, they know how to push off at the end of the route, too.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Good yardage there on first down. Exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs. Keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
On second down, here's Lawrence. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And the Jags are going to be set up with a 1st and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Out of the gun, it's Lawrence. Touchdown, Jaguars! Christian Kirk on the receiving end of that touchdown pass from Trevor Lawrence. And the Jaguars have got it back to within a score.
As they began this last drive, things weren't exactly looking up for this offense. But after what they just did, putting the ball in the end zone, that took them away from the brink of possibly being knocked out of this game.
Now McManus for the extra point. It's up and good. This becomes a 21-14 ball game now. The drive there only spanning 3 plays, and it results in a touchdown for Jacksonville. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Tennessee offense set to go again. They've seen their 21-0 advantage cut to just 7, so time to go back to work here, 1st and 10. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Just his 2nd incompletion so far. He's 8 for 10. I think he'll take 80%.
There's no doubt that he will, but if you're the defensive play caller, you better circle what you just dialed up on your play sheet and come back to it, because you just caused an incompletion. You need a few more of those.
An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25.
Levis back to throw. And just not enough on the throw there. Down around his feet and incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go three and out here and get the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
Back to throw, it's Levis. And he works his way past the line of scrimmage and then slides to a hole. He'll wind up getting 4 yards there on his own, but it also brings up fourth down.
Nice call on defense, rolling out the nickel package for that big third down play, and he did an excellent job locking down coverage and forcing him to try and run for it, and he doesn't get there, which brings up a big fourth down call.
Here's Ryan Stonehouse now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. Taken in at the 22. A 46-yard boot, but just 36 following a pretty decent return of 10 yards. And it will be first and 10 as they take over. Out comes the Jaguar offense now as they get set to take over. They came out not so hot. The first quarter, they were sputtering a little bit, but they seem to have stayed the course and really righted the ship here in the second.
Well, let's face it, all the preparation that goes into getting ready for a game, all the scouting reports, the practice, the repetition. Sometimes you hit a little bit of a lull to start things off. Maybe you get a little flat, but if you put in that time, you put in that effort, it can come back to you. That's what we're seeing so far.
Now can they keep that momentum going? And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 48 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
On first down, right back to ETN. And he's down right around midfield after a gain of 2, maybe 3.
They went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
Second and 7. From midfield now, Lawrence gets this quickly to Ingram. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there, because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
This is really impressive, because when the offenses are running RPOs, things move very quickly. Fake, ball's out of his hands, and they're trying to hit him in the gaps downfield. And instead, the defender reacts so well that he makes a play on it, and the ball falls incomplete.
Lawrence, that is incomplete.
Tight end has become a bigger and bigger part of the passing game in the NFL, but if you drop the football, that position could get swapped out with a wide receiver in that spot, a running back in that spot. There are other ways they can go if you're not going to catch the ball.
And that's not just his first drop, his second drop of the game. On play action, Lawrence. And that will be incomplete. Fourth down now as the Titans defense holds up in coverage.
I think it's safe to say that he's made some questionable decisions out there so far. Forced some throws into tight coverage. He's already been picked off in this game. Fourth down now, but he was fortunate on that one not to have another turnover on his ledger.
The kick by McManus is good. Now bringing back within 4. So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
are splitting the uprights. McManus to kick it away. This fielded right at the goal line. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And Charles, a very uninspired effort the last time we saw them out there. It was a quick three and out, then they punted the football.
Yeah, and you never want to get stopped so soundly during a series, but what would be even worse now is letting it happen again right here. They've got to get going.
Levis to throw on first and 10 here. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Hopkins. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. 16 yards right off the bat and a first down.
And he's turning in a nice performance. Remember, he had the touchdown earlier, and this time he's able to beat double coverage to grab it.
I think that if he weren't worried about a taunting penalty, he'd run by the opposing team's bench and say, guys, two's not going to be enough. You better get some more guys trying to cover me. He knows how to get open downfield.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Well, partner, I don't think it's any secret that any running back wants to be able to see a hole open so that he can gallop through it. But in this case, he had to slow down. There was really no hole there, and he took a big hit in order to get that 1 yard.
Henry again on second down. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of 9.
This guy's well on his way now to a big game on the ground. It's another good run there. Puts him over the century mark in yardage, and we're still in the second quarter.
The Titans on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And he will have a Titans first down. At least it would appear that way. He didn't get it by much, but yes, they do get the conversion on 3rd and 1.
Well, someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? A lot of it's been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on 3rd down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. So after some runs, now they'll throw with Levis. Open man, that's Henry. And a gain of 4 gets him right to the midfield stripe.
It's funny, throughout the time that we've been together, when we talk with running backs about the ability to catch the ball, their eyes light up when they talk about open field and having one-on-one matchups, don't they?
Yeah, they do. And that's the reason why. What we just saw, shedding those tackles, and that's what they're used to doing.
It is, and it starts at the beginning of the play, a one-on-one matchup if someone's trying to cover them. But they also like those one-on-ones downfield after the catch when they're running with the ball. They think they're going to win those, too.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. 7th play of the drive upcoming here on 3rd and 6. Levis sets up to throw here. Complete.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
Here's Ryan Stonehouse now. He'll boot it away from about his 35. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line.
Travis Etienne of the Jags offense set to take over again here. They're behind in the first half here, CD, but it's not through any fault of their running back. He's had a strong start to this one.
And you're right about that, partner, because watching him play, you would think that his team is in the lead. He has been a lot of fun in this contest. Now let's see if they can actually make something happen and put more points on the board behind his efforts.
Yeah, I'm curious to see, Charles, if they can play complementary football and get that passing game going as well.
A nice looking play to start the drive down the middle and complete. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
Any questions of how they'd approach this drive were answered right there. They come out throwing, and they get a nice pickup here toward the end of the first half.
First down now, but that clock rolling. Lawrence.
And that went too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's incomplete.
I know coaches tell us all the time that having a powerful arm isn't the number one thing they look for in a quarterback. But when you're trying to throw inside routes and you need to put some heat on it, it helps have the big gun. In this case, just a little bit too much.
Now a second and 10. Here's Lawrence to throw. Man open, here is Jones. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. The catch and run pays off to the tune of 35 yards.
The teams practice their plays during the week. They're hoping that it's going to pay off on game day. So it sure has to feel good for them when they hit them during a game. And they hit that one there for big yardage.
So the big play gets them all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Here's Lawrence. Looking left sideline, incomplete.
Nice progress down the field was halted by that incompletion. They could try for some safe yards here to get things moving again, or keep throwing it and pushing it downfield to try and pick up bigger yardage.
Here's second and 10. Draw play, ETN. 5 yards, now it's third and 5.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
They'll come up facing third and 5. Now Lawrence to throw. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. So another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about, a lot of different looks, and he seems a little bit confused trying to complete passes.
The kick by McManus is good, and that'll bring him back within a point. So the 3 points here, they're still down, but they put somewhat of a dent into that lead going into the break.
Anything helps when you're trying to chip away at a lead, but they do know that they're going to need a little bit better effort in the second half.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
That's a heck of an effort from Josh Allen getting in there defensively. So we've reached halftime in a wild first half. We'll take a minute to catch our breath as we now go downstate to Orlando and check in with Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome in everyone to our downtown Orlando studios in this EA Sports Halftime Report. It was Derrick Henry, as he normally does, making his impact felt in that first half. He's already over 100 yards rushing for the game and has a touchdown run as well.
Okay, Coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. these offenses have been in fine form. What will the second half bring us as we are underway in quarter three? Taken at the goal line. And he won't quite make it to the 25. Out come the Titans now. They'll have it first on offense to start the third. And they've got the lead, CD. What do you expect from them in this second half?
Well, I like what they were able to do on the ground in the first half because they had a lot of success running the ball, and I certainly think we'll see more of that. But I'd keep an eye on that defense, and I think their coaches up in the box will do the exact same thing. If they start to see one or two guys start to creep towards the line of scrimmage, that'll be licensed to take some shots downfield.
Second half begins with a run by Henry. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24.
Now, give them credit for trying, but there's no fooling the defense with that call. They were reading run, and they set up to stop the run and then execute it.
Now second and nine. They'll run it again with Henry. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead.
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed him down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
Levis on third down. Jaguar pressure and a Jaguar sack. Brought down by Trayvon Walker on the pass rush.
To me, the defense is looking a little gassed near the end of the first half, but they'll come out of the locker room with a little extra spring in their step. Wonder what they did at halftime to get them so motivated.
I don't know, but that sack looked good. Now let's see if they can build on the momentum of that play. On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. Good open field tackling there. A 50-yard punt followed by just a 1-yard return. Here comes the Jags offense now. Time for their first possession of half number two. Lawrence bringing the Jaguars up first and 10. At their own 23. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Jones has it. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And they'll be left with a second and about a foot. Lawrence will throw. Throwing, completing, quick to Calvin Ridley. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. A give to ETN running right. And he'll be pretty well stopped in his tracks, giving the yard up to the 42. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
On second down, Lawrence. And he's going to be blocked. Roger McCreary able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
And this dominant defensive performance continued on that play. This poor quarterback has now received the protection he needs and has had to pick himself up off the turf far too often.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans' 45-yard line. That was no third and two. That was third and 16, but they get the conversion anyway.
That's a play that'll likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
So operating from Tennessee territory now, here's first and 10.
at the 45-yard line. Lawrence's throw taken in by Ridley here. And he's got this down to the 35. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
But certainly as a fan, you get a little bit nervous when you see him make those kind of throws. But they work on that in practice more than we know. And most of them now know their limits and know what they can get away with. And there's a completion right there.
Back to the ground with ETN. Azeez Al-Shaair, former 49er, in on the tackle.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. Makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
Now Lawrence. Screen play. Here's ETN. A little juke. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. A 14-yard first down pickup for the Jaguars.
And when you're throwing the ball downfield really well like they have been on this drive, it's really a nice time to work one of the screen plays in. One of my favorite play callers in the game has always told me he starts every game with 10 to 12 screens, because if he starts feeling the pressure from the defense, he uses their aggressiveness against them.
And that is caught. It's Ridley. And the Jaguars are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line.
Just picking up yardage in bunches here these last few plays. They have moved right down the field. And just like that, they're going to be set up for the first and goal.
Looking to throw, Lawrence. Got his man, it's caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. Christian Kirk on the receiving end of that touchdown pass from Trevor Lawrence. And the Jaguars have taken the lead here in this third quarter. So a very strong first drive in the second half, Charles, as they turn that halftime deficit into a third quarter lead.
And they were pretty purposeful there, weren't they? Measured in their approach. But boy, they executed awfully well moving the ball down the field.
And now they'll empty the backfield here as they elect to go for two. On the draw, here's Lawrence. And he is not going to make it to the goal line. So the defense holds, and this remains a 5-point game. You know, we've discussed this before, and we've seen it at practices, extra periods being put in for the offense on these 2-point tries. But the defense, they're beefing up their support as well in practice.
They absolutely have to. If people are going to go for two and try and gain those advantages and make it tougher on your team as the game goes along, you have to be in a position to stop those. You can't let them get the advantage. So, yes, the defensive teams, they're putting in that extra time on 2-point plays as well.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. Now the Titans getting set to go. See if they can put this drive in the end zone, Charles, because it's been a little bit of a rough go at times. They've had to punt the football a ton in this ball game because of stalled out drives.
So are you saying that you're kind of tired of seeing the punter run out there and do his thing during this game? Is that what you're trying to say?
I'm okay with it. I have a feeling that this offense, they don't want to see the punter again.
And frankly, the punter doesn't want to run out there anymore himself. He'd love to see his offense put together a drive and give his leg a rest.
114 yards for him on the ground now, as he has been terrific here this afternoon. Ball on the 27. Here's second and a couple. Henry will get it. He's been busy today. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a third and two. That time they're able to bottle him up, but he's having a really nice game.
I agree with that. Let's just go big picture, right? Every back that's in the Hall of Fame had carries where they didn't gain yardage or they lost yardage, but you stick with them, don't you? When they're having a good game, keep feeding them.
And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. That's good for 9 yards as they convert on the third down play.
I think I saw a lot of shoulders just drop there. And what I mean by that is they finally were able to relax a little bit because that was an important play call. They needed to pick up that first down at this stage of the game.
Yeah, couldn't afford another quick drive and out. A first down carry for Henry. Yeah, he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went 3 and out.
So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Again, it's Henry. And he's taken down inside the 30. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first. It's been an excellent day for him running the football, no doubt, as he continues to soar well past 100 yards.
Yeah, it almost feels like he can just grab his briefcase and head home after putting in a full day's work at the office, doesn't it?
In motion is Phillips. Now they'll fake the jet sweep here and throw off play action. Going for it all. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had it and dropped it. That is an unforced error there, and it takes away what could have been a touchdown.
If I'm making excuses, and I am, sometimes the sun can be difficult on a ball like that. That looked like it was going to be right there, but it's in and out of his hands. And a potential big play goes by the wayside.
A 20th carry now for Derrick Henry. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. That good for 19 and a first down.
A good run there off right tackle in an old school NFL football. The right side, the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
Oh, how about this on first and goal? And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. He'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal. Defensively, they had that one pretty well figured out.
Yeah, one of the things about this play, it can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion, and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on second and goal. Working from the gun, here's Levis. And this is incomplete.
No coverage bust by the defense here. They did a nice job accounting for everybody, and that led to an incompletion.
Big play coming here. It's 3rd and goal. Now Levis. And that is, I think he caught it. He did, but they say out of bounds. Here's the incomplete.
That was a difficult catch, and I admire the fact that he actually caught the football. Worked so hard to get his feet down in bounds, tried to do the toe tap.
Now Mike Vrabel, unsure of that last call. He's going to throw out the red flag. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How's the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at to see if it all comes together.
After review of the play,
so the decision to challenge does not pan out, and that's also going to cost him a timeout. Here's Nick Folk now on for the field goal from the right hash, and this one just a chippy. Folk's kick is good, and that will cut the lead down to just 2. So give him 3 on that drive. You know, normally you'd say, we'll take it, but the way points have been flying around, it feels like a little bit of a letdown.
Yeah, you just have to wonder, are field goals going to be enough? Because as you pointed out, the way touchdowns have been scored, does kicking a field goal actually put you at a disadvantage the rest of the way?
Let's go out there. Come on with it, man.
is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Johnson now returning. Here comes Johnson on the return. And he returns this to the 22. Trevor Lawrence and the Jacksonville Jaguars back again. He really continues to pick apart this defense. Last drive, perfect, and it culminated in his third touchdown pass.
As long as we've been doing this, how many times has a player in this type of a zone described the game as really slowed down?
Yep.
So right now, instead of warp speed,
it's snail's pace.
Oh, snail's pace for him, and he can do whatever he wants. Feels like he has all the time in the world to throw the ball, and his offensive line has been giving him that.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Speed is the name of the game when it comes to RPOs, and sometimes you can be a little too quick, thus inaccurate, incomplete.
Third quarter of a two-point game, a good one so far. Here's second and 10. Now Lawrence.
Pressure comes, and the Titans able to bring him down.
That's Azeez Al-Shaair getting through for the sack that time.
This is a little hard for me to compute because I'm watching sack after sack happen, but somehow they're still behind in the game. I would expect all of this defensive pressure to translate to them taking a lead, and thus far, it hasn't happened. Time's winding down. They don't want to waste this type of performance from these ace pass rushers.
So now after the sack of Lawrence, the Jags looking at a third and long.
They'll look to throw here. And that is incomplete.
And that's a really good job there defensively. They went into this possession knowing that they needed to get a stop. They're in a tight ball game, and they got it done. Great work to force the three and out. Got the football right back for their offense. They've got to go to the sidelines feeling pretty good about themselves and encouraging their offensive mates to get some points.
He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. It'll be a 39-yard punt, no return. And they will take over first and 10. The Titans offense now, they get set to head back out here. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it, forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, that's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. Levis's throw pulled in by Hopkins. And down he goes at the 49, a 3-yard pickup.
It's a pickup of three. Brings up second and seven at their 49-yard line.
And they'll come up second and seven. Inside handoff, Henry. Down the numbers. There he goes. Titans. Derrick Henry with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Titans have retaken a third quarter lead. So what was already a game to remember becomes even more so as that touchdown run, a lengthy one, takes him over 200 yards now for the game.
And I love the fact that to get over 200, it took a pretty good sprint, didn't it? I mean, a lot of times you get 1 or 2 yards and, oh, he's over 200 yards. But that really put an exclamation point on the game he's having. Fantastic. A lot of fun to watch.
Extra point up and good by Folk. And the lead is up to 5. There's the Titan kick team as they run up and send this one away. Out of the end zone comes Johnson. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Jacksonville set to go again offensively.
These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least two first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
Azeez Al-Shaair in to make the stop.
That's a really good gain right there. They pick up 5 yards halfway to a first down. The only problem now in the huddle, everyone's going to want to touch the football. Be a lot of chattering now because they've seen that they can move the line of scrimmage.
Now Lawrence, and that one knocked away and incomplete. Nice job defensively on what will be the final play of the third quarter. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we play three quarters. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Back now in Jacksonville. It's Jaguar football, but a little work to do for them. They trail here as we start the fourth. The Jaguars on third down. They've struggled to the tune of 2 for 8 so far. This will be 3rd and 5. From the shotgun, Lawrence. He's got his target. That's complete. Still on his feet. Touchdown, Jaguars. Zay Jones, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Jaguars answer back with a touchdown of their own to take a fourth quarter lead. So from 3 scores down, these guys have fought all the way back to grab the lead. And I'll just tell people what happened when they went up 3 scores. I wrote on your paper 2 words, game over, and now I'm eating those words. I was wrong.
Little salt, little pepper, yeah, goes down pretty easily.
I will admit when I make a mistake.
Well, it looked like it was going that way. This is one of those paging Frank Reich moments, and I can't believe I just brought that up, because Frank Reich at Maryland in college did it to my Tennessee Volunteers, and that was a big reason why my team lost.
Sounds like you still harbor some pain from that game.
You know, we still got more time to work it out with the doctor.
So that effort gives him a 3-point cushion and guarantees that a field goal going forward won't beat them.
Yeah, that's really good strategy, because that's all you care about, not getting beat at this stage. At least give your team a fighting chance.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Here's Tennessee ready to begin this drive offensively. We certainly have a good one on our hands. They're trailing after that last touchdown, but now a chance for this offense to try to snag that lead right back here in the fourth quarter. Couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day, 1-score game, 1st and 10 here. They begin with Henry. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground. Honed in on it and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
2nd down, here's Levis. He finds his man, complete. It's Phillips down the left sideline. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he gets all the way down inside the 20-yard line. A big play there on the catch and run. And even 60 yards.
And the offense is saying to itself right now, if only they were all this easy, because he was wide open. And once he made the catch, plenty of room to work his way downfield. That was a breakdown on the defensive side of the ball, one that they want to fix immediately.
A real field flipper there, as all of a sudden they've got a 1st down in the red zone. Levis to throw off play action.
And a catch made by Hopkins. And he'll be out of bounds, taking it just shy of the 10 at the 11 or the 12. It'll go down as a gain of 6, and it'll be second down.
Little bootleg here, Levis.
That's a Titans touchdown. DeAndre Hopkins, an 11-yard touchdown.
And the Titans have taken a fourth quarter lead.
Those are the types of plays in these moments they were hoping from this young rookie, able to put him up here in the fourth quarter.
How about the kid? You just mentioned it, the fourth quarter. This is when you have to make those winning plays. That's what he just did. Doesn't ensure anything, but he certainly gave his team a heck of a chance, didn't he?
Fulk connects on the extra point, and that will make this a four-point game. There's the Titan kick team as they run up and send this one away.
Johnson won't return this, and the football will come out to the 25.
And out now comes Jacksonville as they get ready to go.
And they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. Lawrence bringing the Jaguars up first and 10
at their own 25-yard line.
On the ground with Bigsby, who starts to drive.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Excellent job on the tackle for loss by Harold Landry, shooting into the backfield.
And they have just not been able to block him at all throughout this game. Seems like every other play, he's doing something in the backfield. Already got 2 sacks. And now here's a tackle behind the line.
Second down is a run with Bigsby.
And this one also slow in developing as he's maybe getting back here to the line of scrimmage, but not much more than that.
Defensively, though, they had a chance there to hit him for a loss. Couldn't get it done.
Looked like someone was able to knife into the backfield, but he wasn't able to get him down. But his compatriots, they were able to grab him at the line of scrimmage and not let him get any further downfield.
Now Lawrence on third and long. The pass complete to Ingram on the crossing route.
And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and we watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know, this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
Now Lawrence on first down.
Over the middle, and it's incomplete.
Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
I'm darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down.
Lawrence.
That's caught on the left side by Kirk. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45.
Lawrence finding Kirk there for the Jaguar first.
Yeah, he's certainly been a huge factor in this when he's got the 2 touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him, double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now.
And a pretty good burst right there as he'll take this down to the 33. 75 yards now for ETN, and he's got a first down.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
And they'll throw on first down with Lawrence. A very quick pass to Ridley. That will go as a pickup of 7 on the 7th play of the drive.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
Man open, here is Jones. Touchdown. Zay Jones, 25 yards for the touchdown. And the Jaguars are once again back in front. A plenty of scoring here of late, and our lead changes hands now in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, they just gave up a touchdown the other end, so they knew that with time getting short, they had to put something together here. And they were able to do so and retake the lead right back.
Extra point from McManus is good, and that gives them a 3-point lead. So that one, an 8-play drive. It spans 75 yards, and it culminates in a Jags touchdown. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. And he takes this near the 25, just a little pass there, call it the 26. Derrick Henry trots back out there and gets ready to go. He is north of 200 yards. Anytime that you can say you're north of 200 yards, you've done something right.
Yeah, you're going to get some big check marks on your grade sheet, and you're going to be in heavy rotation on all the highlight shows, and you might even make a magazine cover or two.
He's hoping for more, the cherry on top maybe, as this game goes forward. They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That good for 19 and a first down.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Running from the gun with Henry. The solid stiff arm. And he's going to get this inside the 30. That is now 19-yard gains on back-to-back plays. He continues to be effective running the football, a big reason that they have the lead.
And I love one of the quotes that I read about him where he said of himself, "I love it when a team just hops on my back and I just carry them along."
They'll try the right side with Henry. And he'll go down right on the edge of the red zone following a pickup of about 7 or 8.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Second down and 3. So after some runs, now they'll throw with Levis. He gets this one to Burks. That catch puts him over 70 yards receiving now as he's got a first down. That time they hit him out of the slot on the drag.
And that route takes some fortitude from the guy running it because he knows he's going through the briar patch, as I like to call it, right? He's trying to work his way through. All that traffic and people wanting to put a little contact on him. Really well done.
Well, they'll run it here on the jet sweep. And this is not going to work as planned. He's going to be met and dropped behind the line of scrimmage. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Well, as a wideout, when you take that handoff and you're coming around the edge, you're expecting to see nothing but empty space in front of you. But if not...
Well, things can go south in a hurry, and that's exactly what we saw on that play with a loss.
Powers passed him at the 5. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
This has been an up and down, back and forth type of a game, hasn't it? Maybe this long drive could take a little bit of the wind out of their sails, kind of settle things down a little bit.
The offense on third down, they're right at about the league average, 40%, 4-for-10. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
Perhaps they overthought this one a little bit. They've been running it real well on this drive, and it was 3rd and short, okay? They decided to throw the football incomplete. Yeah, they might have thought just a little bit too hard about that play selection.
Folks, kick is good. And in the fourth quarter, this game is tied. Well, you talk about clutch. That one was right down Broadway, and this game's all even here in the fourth.
Yeah, he didn't leave any doubt, did he? Good snap, good hold, dead center. Almost like a big-time golfer in a major, firing at a pin from the fairway, trying to win the tournament going down the stretch.
Now this one setting up for a great finish, all tied in the fourth as the kick's away. Out of the end zone comes Johnson. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down officially at the 21. The Jaguars getting set to go. And we essentially have a brand new ball game. After that last field goal has tied us all up, we brace for what should be an exciting rest of this fourth quarter. Lawrence bringing the Jaguars up 1st and 10 at their own 21. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Throw right side is going to be caught by Kirk. And he's upended after a gain of 4 up to the 25-yard line. They like going to him in the slot. He catches another one.
I think this comes under the heading of until they stop him. Why not go back to it? He has something going really well. Great working relationship with the guy throwing the ball, and they keep making the connection.
Off the play fake. Here's Lawrence. Airing it out, looking for Ridley. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And they get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A big pickup of 38.
But this game has certainly had no shortage of offense. Both teams have been revved up from the start. And here's yet another big play. Boy, both defenses have just got to be dragging out there because they've been run ragged throughout.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for 1st and 10. Out of the gun, it's Lawrence. Titan defense steps up here, and down he goes. Roger McCreary able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his 3rd sack of the afternoon.
I don't know what else can be said about this pass rush. They have been sensational. CD, that is now 6 sacks for them.
And how many times do we talk to offensive coordinators and they say a sack is a result of everyone on offense not doing their job? But let's be honest about this one. This is the offensive line unable to counter the pass rush. They've been teeing off all game long.
So after the sack, a scenario you certainly don't work on too often. 2nd and 24.
Running out of the gun with ETN.
And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
Getting down to the good stuff. All tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports. Boy, here's a big one. You can just feel it. This is third down now. Here's Lawrence. Behind his receiver and incomplete.
Oh boy, this sets up for a huge call now on fourth down, because you can try the long field goal, you could go for it, or you could punt and play for overtime. I am so glad, partner, that I don't have to make those kind of decisions. Let's see what they decide.
Here's Logan Cook now, as he's on for the fifth time here today. That one sails out of bounds. The side judge will walk it off. And he says it went out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Nice punt. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
He's got Henry fighting through and out of bounds across the 15-yard line.
I think the best offenses love to get the ball to their running backs in open space, because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play. Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete. The way he's throwing the football today, almost a surprise when he doesn't complete a pass like happened there, but he needs a few more to get his guys downfield.
Well, the way he's throwing it leads him to believe that he's going to get those completions, and that means the guys going out for passes, they'll run even harder because they expect it as well.
Levis to throw. They set up the screen for Henry, and able to get this across the 20 before going out of bounds.
And that's a gutsy call there on third and short, because that's a play that's got a good chance of being blown up in the backfield for a big loss of yardage. But nice job out wide to gather in that screen pass, use his blockers well, and pick up the first down.
Levis. He's going to look downfield for Henry. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
I don't know if you need the big shot right there or not, because you've still got time to work some of the shorter stuff and try to get into field goal range. They did go for the big one there. It would have been nice, but it winds up incomplete.
Levis, he'll look to throw it. And his throw is incomplete. Third and long coming up. Defensively, you pressure the quarterback or drape all over the passing lane?
Yes, that's exactly what you do. It's both, because they're not mutually exclusive. They may have been at one time in football, but not anymore. You want to have that pressure. If you have a big-time pass rusher, send him after the quarterback, and then make sure you blanket the field.
Here's Levis. Open man, that's Henry. And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40.
And when you have success throwing the football, the old cliche becomes true. The playbook opens up wide, and these screen passes, they become even more difficult to stop.
Plenty of time and 2 timeouts still at their disposal. First and 10 here. Throwing now, here's Levis. He'll complete this one to Okonkwo. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. He has been terrific today, hasn't he?
Yeah, absolutely. Run flawless 2-minute drill right here. This has been quarterbacking 101 with a flourish.
This is first and 10. Henry up the middle. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout, as the clock stops here with 46 seconds left to play.
Here comes second down. A shotgun handoff to Henry. And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And he will have a Titans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. The Jaguars now will use the last of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game. Two timeouts still available in this final minute. It's first and 10 now. Now a handoff to Henry.
Partner, they're clearly saving those timeouts, but they still have to work with some urgency to put themselves in the right position.
Second down, 8 yards to go. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout, as he'll stop it with 11 seconds remaining in the ball game. So here now is the kicker, Nick Folk. This to almost certainly win the football game. And the 38-year-old vet able to split the uprights. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. And you know, in an era of cost-cutting and maximizing your roster, this is a club that does not skimp on special teams, and in these situations, it pays dividends.
And that's great vision by the organization. When the difference between winning or losing depends on who you have kicking the ball, would you rather have a street free agent out there or a solid pro like this? Answer's pretty evident to me.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. They'll come up first and 10 here. A final shot now for Lawrence. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over.
Well, it took us until the final play, Charles, to officially decide a winner, although on that last play they were so backed up it would have taken a miracle and they couldn't get that miracle done.
Well, I like how you stayed with it, because we both knew that this had to go down to the last play and neither side was going to exhale until that play concluded, because we've seen the improbable before. A couple of laterals, maybe some poor defense on the back end. They might have gone all the way to the end zone. In this case, though, it didn't happen. Perhaps next time.